Hey everybody, this is Ori from AstroWeb, and I'm going to introduce to you the Shopify buy button. Okay, so what is a buy button? A buy button is a way for you to embed or put your products on other websites, your partners' websites, your affiliates, your friends, your cousins, etc. Okay, so it's an easy way for you without any coding to create some kind of a nice view of your product or products, and then allow someone else to integrate those, embed them on their site, and maybe you can share revenue, or you can just be friendly, or et cetera. So how do you do this? And I want to show you some examples. Number one, you actually have to go and add a sales channel for the buy button, okay? So I click here on add if you don't have it already, and I scroll down and I go to the buy button and I add it, okay? This is going to take 20 or 30 seconds. It's going to load, you're going to integrate it, allow the buy button channel to integrate with your site. Okay, that's basically what's going on. So you're going to look at the permissions, your buy button will be able to do all these cool things. Okay, so I'm going to do it, and I'm going to let it run. Okay, so now I'm going to start and create my first button. So let's click on create. So you see here there's a sales channel, another one called buy button. So there's two types. Number one is that you can actually embed on another site one single product, like the product, the picture, the price, etc., and a button called, you know, add to cart or buy. The other one, you can do a collection. So a collection is a group of products, like a category. You can embed multiple. So let's show you both, right? So the first one is product. Now you're going to be able to see all of the products that you have in your system. You can search for one. For example, this is my demo site. And I want to sell, let's say, this one, classic backpack, okay? So I typed it in, and it's this one, and I can only select one, as you see, okay? I clicked on select. Now I'm going to customize the look and feel of how it looks. So everything I do, I'm going to do on the left. On the right, I'm going to see a preview, and I can actually see how it looks based on different devices, which is really important. Before you launch it, you want to test that, okay? So what do I have? Style, I have just a few things, right? Basic, it's just a cut button. You want to allow them to have a button. Classic is image, you know, price, etc. And full view is a little bit more, right? You can kind of like a mini product page, okay? Then let's go back to basic. Then you can specify what happens when someone actually adds to cart. So for example, if you add to cart, you'll have an add to cart here, right? So you can see a cart right here. Let me actually remove this, start from the beginning. My cart is empty, add to cart, okay? And it's added, okay? So you have like a mini cart on your other site, okay? Or you can do direct to checkout, okay? So there's no mini cart, you click buy now. So instead of add to cart, it became a buy now, and it sends you from the other site to our site in order to just proceed to checkout, okay? What else do we have? The other one is open product detail page. So if I click, I don't like this basic, I like this one better. I click on add to cart, just adds to cart, and then I have to check out here. Okay, so I can see how it looks in different ways. Okay, great. What else? Let me see if I'm missing anything. Full view. Okay, so some of these styles obviously have different selections, but really you're going to look at the maximum of these three selections, which we just did. Okay, button style. Now you're going into layout, styling, colors and size and fonts and things like that. So most of the things are going to be right here, right? So if you make this is kind of rounded corners, you can make it more rounded, less rounded, you know, boxy, and change the width, right? Again, you're trying to make an easy way for another site to embed things. So you want to make sure you fit their style as best as you can. Okay, background, these are the colors. I'm going to choose some interesting colors so you can kind of see the contrast. Okay, the text itself, let's kind of go darker. And the font, just say I want to change to this. And the size of the font. Okay, you can see here, let's go back to the big one. Okay, now I can go here, image size, right? And customize that. I can show additional product images if there are, which is kind of nice. And I can customize the actual text, right? Add to cart. Let's just call it cart. Okay, just for example, right? Show quantity field. They can also add the quantity. I want to buy three, or I want to add three to my cart, for example. Okay, and then you can customize colors and fonts, etc. This is really the same, right? For example, I want to enlarge the price, okay, right here. Again, every time you make changes, always check all of these. It's really, really important. And when you embed it on the external site, test it again. Okay. Next one is shopping cart. So if you do select, you know, add to product or the product details and not this one, because here you don't have a shopping cart with the direct to checkout. So you have shopping cart and you can change the words, the word of this. Obviously, if you have you want to change the words or you have a different language, you can change these things. So hello, cart. And then subtotals, right? This one, you can change it, for example, to total. And then you can have a note. This is a test. You can see it here. And then the checkout button text and the empty cart. So how do you get to empty cart? You have to have an empty cart. So it's empty. You can see that. Really simple. Really simple. Again, colors that are really simple. Okay. Once you finish that, okay, and you also have one more advanced setting, which you can open a click in a new window or in the same tab. Once you finish that, whatever you selected, you're going to go to the next step, and you're going to give this code, copy this code, and give it to the other developer, right? So you're going to give it to the other partner, the other site. They'll embed it. And the good thing is, if they want to change it a little more, they can actually change some of the styling, like the margins and the colors and the fonts, all of that stuff that we created before. They can actually change it via code, HTML, CSS, or they can actually, you know, ask you to change something. So you copy it, you give it to them, and that's it. Here below, these are just links. If you have one of these platforms, there's some documentation to kind of help you with it. Okay, for example, WordPress. You can see all these instructions, okay? So once you finish, okay, cool, that's it. You give it to them, and then you move on. I'm going to show you a second one, collection, right? So before, we made a single product to embed on another site. Now, for example, let's say I want to embed all of these four. I have a collection, a category page called Adidas. So I go here, excuse me, and I click on Adidas. I can only select one collection at a time. And everything you're going to see is going to look basically the same as before, but obviously, you have more products. Here's on mobile. So you see here mobile, it's really kind of smushed, you know, vertically, right? And everything else is going to be the same. So you can go here, click on event settings, change the layouts, everything we just did. Let me see. And that's it pretty much. So again, so I hope you enjoyed this video. It's really simple. Play with it. If you have questions, I'm happy to answer. You can comment. That's it. Hope you enjoyed. I'll be making a lot more videos for Shopify. Thank you very much. Appreciate the time.